How long does it take to franchise your business? The answer is 90 to 120 days, but you need to know a lot more. There's different processes in place, legal, franchise development, and accounting, and we're going to discuss the steps, the timing, and what you need to know to win at franchising. Generally, it takes 90 to 120 days to franchise your business. And some people are in a rush and some are not. Maybe you have franchise buyers ready and waiting to go. Or maybe you want to go through a methodical process to develop your franchise. To do it the right way, generally, it's a 90 to 120 day process. And what's involved in the process? Well, there's legal, franchise development, and accounting. And in many ways, these processes are going to be happening on parallel tracks as you franchise your business. And we're going to discuss each one of them. So again, 90 to 120 days to go from where you are today, successful business owner, one location, multiple locations. You want to franchise your business, which ultimately is going to mean at the federal and state level, have the ability to offer and sell franchises, ultimately sign a franchise agreement and have a franchisee open up an outlet. So 90 to 120 days, we have legal, franchise development, and accounting, three processes that are going to be happening at the same time. And if you're working with the right legal or franchise development team, these are things that they should be coordinating for you. So when we work with our clients, we're coordinating all of these processes. We're really quarterbacking these processes. And let's start with legal. So when you think about the legal processes involved in franchising, I want you to think about your trademarks, developing what's going to be your franchise disclosure document, setting up your corporate entities, and then ultimately registering your franchise offering at the state level. So trademarks, let's start with your trademarks. Now, there's going to be significant variation in your franchising process depending on whether or not your trademarks, your brand name, is registered with the United States Patent and Trademark Office. If it's not, the first step we're going to take, and one of the first steps in the franchising process is that our team is going to be evaluating your trademarks from a couple of perspectives. One, are they protectable? And two, can we get registration with the United States Patent and Trademark Office? So in this legal process, there's going to be a trademark evaluation. If your trademarks are not registered, applications will be filed for registration with the United States Patent and Trademark Office. That'll be done within the first month of your franchising process. Now, keep in mind, obtaining registration with the United States Patent and Trademark Office is over a six-month process. So while it's 90 to 120 days to franchise your business, if you don't have registered trademarks, it's very possible that you may be selling your first number of franchises before you even obtain USPTO trademark registration. So on the legal board here, we have your trademarks. And one of the first steps, we're going to be reviewing and registering your trademarks. Second is preparing your franchise disclosure document. And that's going to happen throughout this 90 to 120 day process where your legal team is going to be preparing your franchise disclosure document, which is ultimately the hub of your franchise offering. And now legally also, you're going to be setting up a new corporate entity, your ABC Franchising Co. Right now you have your corporate entity that you operate your business under, but what's going to happen during the franchising process? We're going to be setting up a new corporate entity that will be your franchisor entity that's going to offer and sell franchises, provide training and support to your franchisees, and ultimately receive initial franchise fees and royalties. So that's your new organization. That's your new corporate entity. Also along the way, we're going to discuss other corporate entities. For example, whether or not it makes economic sense and legal sense to set up an intellectual property holding company. And then last on the legal spectrum. So we've protected your trademarks. We've prepared your franchise disclosure document. We've set up your corporate entities. Your FDD, your franchise disclosure document, is now issued. Well, now, depending on the state where you operate and where you'll be selling franchises, we need to file applications for registration. So those franchise registration states, New York, California, Illinois, Washington, Maryland, Virginia, and others, before you can offer or sell a franchise in those states, even though your franchise disclosure document has been issued, Well, we need to wait until we obtain registration in those states. So 90 to 120 days, or maybe even 60 to 120 days, we've prepared and issued your franchise disclosure document at the federal level. You're a franchisor. Now, depending on the states where you're going to sell, there's maybe an additional process where we have to register your franchise disclosure document with the state. Every state is different on how long they take to process your registration application. The vast majority of the states don't require registration. The franchise registration states do, and the process there could take anywhere from 35 to 90 days, depending on the state, depending on the time of year. Naturally, these are all things we'd be discussing in the beginning of the process as we plan the launch and eventual sale of franchises. So from a timing perspective, your legal involves trademark protection, FDD development, setting up your corporate entities, and then registering your franchise disclosure document at the state level. As we're going through this process, naturally, you're going to be interacting and involved in the development process. We would be also reaching out to and conferring with your accounting team. Also, if you're a company that's big enough and you have your corporate counsel, we'd be conferring with them, or maybe your intellectual property counsel. So on the board of steps that are involved, we have legal, development, accounting. And again, they're all happening at the same time, right? They're all on parallel tracks. On the development end of the spectrum, what's going on there? Well, we're modeling out what a best practices franchise system is going to look like for you. Reviewing other systems, preparing a competitive analysis, right? And ultimately going to be recommending structures. What's the best franchise development strategy? Individual unit sales, multi-unit sales. What's the right positioning for your initial franchise fee? How about multi-unit franchise sales? Do we go with a percentage-based royalty structure, or do we do fixed-fee royalty structures? Really, all the franchise development underpinnings. So those are conversations that are happening in the development process that's happening the same time as the legal process. Why? Because they need to mirror one another, right? As we're setting up different franchise development structures, franchise fees, royalties, development strategy, that's going to be implemented on the legal end. So also on this development front, happening the same time, is preparation of your operations manual, which your operations manual, it's confidential, it's not publicly disclosed, but it's the guide you're going to be giving to your franchisees and that you'll be updating over time to communicate with them, brand standards, operating requirements, supplier requirements. Traditionally, operations manuals have been printed or digital files. Now they're becoming much more interactive, videos and an online forum that is closed off to your franchisees and confidential. And then also on the development front, your sales strategy. So I think some of the best sales strategies for new franchisors is organic growth. Sell to those franchisee candidates that know your brand, that are organically attracted to your brand. Why? It's more cost effective. But as we're going through this development process, right, that 90 to 120 day process, sales strategy needs to come into play. And maybe it's not super advanced, but you need to add a franchise sales page to your website where you talk about your brand story, your unique value proposition. Sure, it's going to get better over time, but this should be happening during the franchising process. Why? Because when we're ready to sell franchises, where are franchisee candidates going to go? We don't want to just give them your FDD. We want them to see about your story, go to your website, and along the way have a presentation about your franchise opportunity. So we have legal, franchise development happening at the same time that we're coordinating during this 90 to 120 day franchising process. There's another component, accounting, right? So within your franchise disclosure document, every franchisor, which in this case will be the new franchise company we set up for you, needs to include financial statements in its FDD. And the rule is you need 3 years of audited financial statements. But the point is we just set up a brand new company. So naturally, you're not going to have 3 years of audited financials. And so what we'll need is you're going to open up a bank account. You're going to deposit some money into that bank account. And the accountant is going to prepare an opening balance sheet. Now, in the franchise registration states, that balance sheet, that opening balance sheet needs to be audited. It's not a big deal, but you need certain accountants to prepare an audited opening balance sheet. And That's something else we're going to be coordinating during your franchising process. Also on the accounting front, we're going to be conferring with your accountant to discuss the best strategy or their recommendations for your new franchise company. What state are we forming it in? What type of entity will it be? Corporation, LLC, and so forth. Also, we're going to talk to your accounting team about maybe setting up an intellectual property holding company. That company would own your trademarks and other intellectual property assets, license it to your franchise company. And why would we potentially do this? Well, we would potentially do this to protect your trademarks, provide legal insulation. So franchising process, franchising your business, it's not just the FDD. The FDD is the hub to everything, but there's parallel processes that our team's going to be coordinating. And again, it's legal, franchise development, accounting. And then ultimately, the next lever, although it's not in technically in this 90 to 120 day period, it's developing a winning strategy, right? No one wins at franchising in year one. Year one's all about the launch of your franchise system and that 90 to 120 day process, getting your registrations and franchise registrations. It's hopefully selling to qualified franchisees that know your brand organically. Year two is seasoning your franchise offering, building that PR story, going deeper on your website, on your presentations. And then years 3 to 5, well, those are acceleration years. And we've done a whole video on that. So 90 to 120 days to franchise your business. Just know there's parallel processes that are happening, legal, franchise development, accounting. And then along the way, we have to focus on winning.